putting on the armor of God is putting on the uniform. And I've tried to tell people, you know, you don't have to leave everything in this world behind to put God first. Just learn to put God first in everything in this world. And then all of a sudden, baseball makes more sense. Running makes more sense. You know, your job makes more sense. And so hopefully we can help parents do that. We can help people do that as we go through this series. We're going to go through, you know, six virtues that can make us champions and make us saints. You gave me a nice little testimonial for my book here, The Light Entrusted to You. You said, the chapter athletics especially speaks to my heart. The journey through these virtues is what makes sports so great. What an incredible way for parents to be able to connect their kids' athletic ventures with their faith journey. So first of all, thanks for the endorsement. I knew I was going to have to get that if I wanted this to be a bestseller. So, but we're going to talk about that here using these six virtues, an acronym of the word sports, starting today with the S. We just want to kind of touch on this whole idea of self-discipline. It's something that I think is pretty essential. As a runner, I knew it was obviously pretty essential. As a baseball player, I'm sure it's essential. And I think in life, it's essential, you know. So I've always thought that the difference between being a mediocre athlete and a champion is probably more what you do when nobody else is watching you. And so as your experience, you know, as your career in sports and being around so many great athletes, you know, what's your thought on that? Do you feel like, you know, the difference between a great athlete and a not so, you know, an average athlete maybe is, you know, how you push yourself. Obviously we're going to need coaches and teammates to push us, but, how has self-discipline played a role in making you so successful in your career?
Yeah, it's the basis of what makes a athlete successful, I think, is that inner discipline to do the things that no one else wants to do when you have to do them. And, you know, talking about this made me think of Babe Ruth and how they used to always say he ate a bunch of hot dogs and drank beer.
Yeah.
You know, maybe he wasn't the most disciplined off the field, but it's a different game now. It's a different sports are different now in how much discipline it does take to be at the top of your line of work. In running, you've got to be disciplined, you know, from the very beginning. You've got to be able to eat right, drink right, train right. And baseball is starting to get to that point too. You know, if I'm not training from October to February and I show up to spring training, you know, having done nothing, having not disciplined myself to put the effort in every single day, I'm not going to get much out of spring training. I'm definitely not going to get much out of the season. And there's going to be a million, you know, minor league kids that are going to pass me by.
Yeah.
So that self-discipline, that discipline of waking up every morning, with a structured plan to make yourself a little bit better every single day, is the basis of how it becomes a great athlete.
Yeah. So, you know, what motivates you to do that? You know, a lot of times when we apply this to faith, we apply this to Catholicism and our growth in virtue. You know, a lot of people look at religion and they look at faith as just a list of no's, like don't do this and don't do this and don't do this. And, you know, if you looked at sports that way, it'd be like, you know, don't drink pop or don't eat junk food or whatever. But how is it more, you know, what is it? You know, I was always said you need a deeper yes. Like you can't just have a motivation of don't do this. There's got to be a greater yes of, yeah, I want to be the best baseball player I can be. I want to be a champion, and not just for myself, but maybe for other people. So what inspires you? What's your deeper yes that pushes you each year to keep going back and pushing yourself and giving your best effort?
Yeah, that's a great question. And you think about purpose, you have to have a purpose. And I always think about, I've played with so many guys that have gotten burnt out playing baseball. And I'm sure you've ran with so many guys that are just burnt out of running. You know, you're just tired of it. I do it every day. I don't want to do it anymore.
Yeah.
And unless you have a deeper purpose, a deeper why, you will get burned out. And for me, that deeper why is I've been giving a gift that is unexplainable, a gift to be able to throw the baseball over 90 miles an hour. Like what, you know, I always talk about my best buddy growing up, Kevin Sellhorst. We played catch together more than any two people ever played catch. He threw the ball just as much as I did growing up as a kid. We practiced the same. He ended up being 5'7", 160 pounds, and I ended up being 6'3", 220 pounds. And, you know, who says he couldn't throw 90, you know? Yeah. God gave me that gift to be able to play baseball, to give me the mind to be able to work hard. And I think when I'm looking at my purpose and my why, it's because I need to honor him with what he's blessed me with.
Yeah.
And that daily knowledge of knowing, you know, that gift is freely given and he could freely take it away at any moment. You know, it's my job to put in the work and make that gift as as prominent as it can be in my life.
Yeah, I'm sure playing in the major leagues, knowing that, you know, you don't know what tomorrow brings, keeps you grateful for that gift. And I know, you know, growing up, you know, we call that grace. You know, God gives us our talent. That's a free gift. You didn't earn that. He gave that to you. He gives us our gifts, our talents, abilities. He died for us. And, you know, that was his gift to us. Our gift to him, I think, is, you know, what we do with those gifts and what we do with those talents. And it's really about love. Like, do we love the Father? Do we want to? And my dad was a great motivator for me. You know, he was always had the stopwatch and he was timing me. And even when I was, you know, 30 meters ahead and I knew I was going to win, I knew my dad's stopwatch is timing me. And I'm like, he's going to know if I don't give my best effort. And so I know that God kind of watches me. He has the stopwatch and he knows my potential. He knows my gifts and talents. And so I want to give my best. I want to say yes to make him proud. And, you know, Spider-Man, yeah, with great power comes great responsibility. We have a responsibility in this life to push ourselves, to use those gifts and talents the best we can.